Abandonment is something that I'm sure just about everyone on planet Earth has experienced in some way, shape, or form. Whether you were the one abandoned or the one abandoning someone or something, it's bound to have happened at least once at some point in your life, even if it's just a very insignificant form of abandonment. And a very common form of abandonment that I've seen many people, including myself, experience is being abandoned by a close friend. That friend, you know, distances themselves from you sometimes for no given reason, starts hanging out with other people you've never met, ignores you when you try to reach out to them, etc. Severe types of abandonment done to someone, especially if that person is at a crucial development stage in their growing life, can really mess said person up, giving them abandonment issues. For instance, if a kid had a bad experience with abandonment at a developmental stage, and as time goes on, his mom or dad would just, you know, try to go to the grocery store for a little, but the kid wouldn't be able to handle being by themselves, so they'd, you know, go with the parents wherever they went. If you couldn't tell, the reason I'm focusing on this concept so much is because the main antagonist of the Steven Universe movie, Spinel's motives stem from being abandoned by Pink Diamond. Now, when it came to the mini leaks slash spoilers related to the movie that would eventually come out on the internet before the movie officially aired, I steered completely clear of all that, so Spinel's name along with her motives to attack Earth were a complete mystery to me until the movie officially aired on television. The only thing I was certain of was that Spinel's motives were going to be related to Rose slash Pink Diamond in some way, shape, or form, since literally every major antagonist Steven has dealt with has been because of something that she's done or didn't do in the past. And what do you know, that was the case with both. The audience learns pretty quickly, like within the first 20 minutes type of quickly, that Spinel is connected to Pink Diamond somehow and Pearl knows who she is. The lyrics of Spinel's debut song, Other Friends, that's top 5 songs in the series for me now, I don't care, gave us a vague hint that she was guaranteed connected to Pink. The lyrics like, what did she, referring to Pink Diamond, say about me, what did she say, what did you do without me, what did you do, implying Pink, you know, abandoned her at some point for an unknown reason. But at the time of these scenes taking place in the movie, we still didn't know what purpose she served to Pink Diamond either. The scuffle between the group ends with everyone but Steven being poofed by a weapon called a Rejuvenator, which is pretty much a gem destabilizer on steroids. This weapon not only poofs a gem, but forces them to reform in their original fresh out of the kindergarten state with no memory of any events that occurred prior to them being poofed by this weapon. After taking their gemstones back to the house, each of them reformed back together one by one, starting with Pearl and ending with Spinel. While Pearl was singing System slash Boot, she gave us Spinel's name, saying she's Steven's new best friend. Her appearance became significantly more different than everyone else for sure, with the exception of Garnet, I suppose, since Ruby and Sapphire reformed individually. You know, this new appearance Spinel had, she literally looks like a character straight out of a Disney movie or the game Cuphead. Her personality also took a 180. She was constantly trying to play goofy games with Steven, like tag or hide and seek, constantly by his side, somewhat distracting him from his goal of returning the other crystal gems to their previous state with all of their memories intact. He wanted that happily ever after back so bad, bro. While in the state, she seemed to get along generally well with the other major characters that were around Steven at the time, but her priority was always Steven. Wherever Steven went, she needed to be in his general presence slash field of vision. There was even a point where Steven tried to leave her behind so he could go look for Amethyst, and she gave him a hard no so he could let her come. This was part of her previous malicious self coming out, but not completely overtaking her person. Steven indirectly helped her begin the process of getting her memories back here, but I'll go over this again later on in the video. After Amethyst returns to normal, the gang decides to tackle Pearl next, hoping that the Sadie Killer and the Suspects concert would help jog her memory. After failed attempts with their song, combined with Amethyst even shapeshifting into Rose while singing, Steven and Greg came up with the idea to fuse. This was top 5 moments in the movie for sure. I love me some fan service fusion. Steg's song, Independent Together, is what brought Pearl back, but also sent Spinel over the edge even more once the song concluded. With Pearl back, she tells Steven that Spinel was Pink Diamond's old playmate. They would constantly goof off together in some garden in space. She runs to the warp pad inside Steven's house where Steven finds her bawling her eyes out. She said she started getting a bunch of feelings flooding back to her. Of course, those feelings aren't necessarily good for her well-being, but at the same time, Steven is happy she's getting her memories back because he wants her to help save the planet so she can turn the ejector off. He asks if she remembers the garden, in which she responds by slamming the warp pad to take Steven to the garden itself with her. Basically, when Pink was going through it on Homeworld with not having a colony, being the black sheep of the Diamond Authority, etc., she would play with Spinel in the garden. Spinel was her sole source of positive, fun energy during that time period. Gotta keep in mind, though, that during this time, Pink was also hard fiending for her own colony more than anything else. That was her, you know, big priority. Of course, the day eventually came when Yellow and Blue found Planet Earth, deciding it would be a good fit for Pink to colonize. Spinel was super excited because it's a brand new place to play. Cue Drift Away, fellas. As Pink is about to leave to start the Earth colony, she, with an annoyed look on her face, tells Spinel to play a game. The game is for Spinel to just stay in the garden and stand still. Pink bailed, never coming back to the garden, not even once. Spinel stood there patiently waiting for her best friend to return for 6,000 years. The only reason Spinel even moved in the first place was because of the gem-wide broadcast that Diamonds put on praising Steven for establishing gem-wide peace. If they didn't broadcast that to every single gem tech screen, she'd still be standing there, bro. Thank God the garden had one of those things. Remembering this is what triggered Spinel to transform back into how she was when she initially attacked Steven. This is what also caused her to transform into her new form for the first time in the recent past as well. Quick side note, not that much time passed from when the broadcast of Steven aired to when Spinel first came to Earth. How the hell was she able to get an injector that big and powerful combined with an incredibly powerful weapon in such a short time frame? Granted, I guess in the show's time, there may have been a big time lapse from the ending of Happily Ever After to when Spinel first showed up, but it couldn't have been that big because it was still light outside. I don't know, man, that just feels like a plot hole to me. Maybe I'm missing something, but I don't know. This broke Spinel horribly. She felt like Pink never even enjoyed her company in the first place. Why did she never come back? What did I do wrong? I shouldn't have listened. You can't count on anyone, even your best friend. Were all things I'm sure were going on through her head, on top of countless other negative thoughts. That's why she gave that hard no to Steven when he was trying to go find Amethyst, because he was afraid he was going to do what Pink did. But she was just saying that instinctively as well, though. Pink went about this horribly. This is giving me flashbacks to when Rose and Pink were first revealed to be the same gem. I remember when this episode first came out, the fandom was split over Pink Diamond as a character slash person, but mostly a person. I was initially one of those people who was kind of anti-Pink Diamond and didn't think her reasoning for doing the fake shattering was valid. Well, at least in the next episode, they attempted to explain as to why Pink Diamond had to live a double life. She tried doing all the things she ended up doing as Rose as Pink, but Yellow and Blue just never gave her the time of day, yada yada. And I was like, okay, I got you. She ain't as bad as I, you know, thought before seeing the last episode. But after this, dog, she's actually throwing. Remember how goofy Pink was acting when she first went to visit the Prime Kindergarten with Pearl? How bored she acted doing the colony work that she so desperately wanted to do, apparently? Like, why was Spinel not there? Like, you know, she apparently wanted to do this boring colony work so bad that, you know, it was enough to ditch her best friend. He wasn't trying to hide her personality from Pearl or anything either, so why was she acting so stingy with Spinel? You know, I get it. You know, Spinel was a bit clingy. She looked kind of clingy in those flashbacks. You know, the way she acted with Steven as well does indicate that. But leaving her by herself, forced to stand still for thousands of years, in what world is that a good idea? Of course she's gonna listen to you, Pink. You're her diamond. Just take her with you, Forehead. Who's to say she wouldn't have made new friends on Earth? Like, the main reason she was so clingy in the first place, I think, was because Pink was the only diamond she would really have physical contact with on a regular basis. She never ended up forming bonds with other gems, which she definitely could have done on Earth. I remember during this part of the movie, I was thinking to myself while watching, okay, they're making Pink look like a cuck again, but I'm sure they'll give a valid reason as to why she did this before the movie ends, right? You thought, I don't like her as a person again, dude. I just can't. I'm sorry. If they're not gonna explain, like, how am I supposed to, I don't get it. Like, look at this. Looking at this makes me want to die, and it's Pink's fault. That is just so hard to, like, oh my God, I can't look. The duet song Found gets Spinel on Steven's side, only for a short time though. After Spinel shuts down the injector, Steven thanks Spinel, quickly brushing her off so he can focus on getting Garnet back to normal. Spinel starts to freak out, feeling used and worried that Steven's going to abandon her just like Pink did, and she's going to be left alone. Granted, you can't really blame her here for getting worried. After what Pink did to her, it's not easy to turn over a new leaf after the first attempt. Spinel restarts the injector as if nothing had changed because, you know, she can't trust Steven now. Their final confrontation was so incredibly emotional to watch. Steven realizing he forgot that his greatest power of all was the power to make change for the better. He was so hyper-focused on things staying exactly how they were before Spinel showed up, he'd forgotten to keep doing what he's best at. Steven telling Spinel he won't force her to change, but she has to, you know, want to become better. But she just thinks every time she changes, she just becomes worse and worse. Thinking if she wasn't good enough for Pink at her peak, then why would she even bother trying anymore? All this emotional turmoil caused by wrongful abandonment to an adorable little gem. I'm very glad she was given her chance at redemption and she can live a happy life. I knew she was going to be redeemed before the movie came out. I mean, this is Steven Universe we're talking about. If White Diamond can get redeemed, of course Spinel can. Like, come on. Maybe it was a tad rushed, but time limits are unfortunate, I suppose. I'd say she got screwed over by Pink harder than anybody else, 100%. She used to be as close to Pink as Pearl eventually became. It's just sad that nobody found her sooner. She had to find out the hard way that Pink lived the rest of her gem days without her until eventually creating Steven. Since Pink wasn't around to take revenge on, Spinel had to resort to taking her unresolved feelings out on what made Pink leave her in the first place, the planet Earth along with the core Crystal Gem team. I'm also glad that Spinel realized getting back into the swing of things with proper friendship is going to take work. Not everything can be perfect all the time and be fixed just like that. There's always work that can be done. Hopefully this won't be the last time we see her. I'm pretty sure season 6 is going to be the final season of the show, so I want her to make a cameo along with the Diamonds at least once that season. I'm sure she'll be in amazing shape too, since all three of the Diamonds are going to be keeping her company. Spinel staying there is their way to have part of Pink still up in Homeworld with them, so Steven doesn't have to leave Earth, and this is also a perfect way for Spinel to work on her friendship skills. Godlike movie though, easily top 5 Cartoon Network show movies I've seen in my life, right up there with Operation Zero and Ed, Edd n Eddy, the big picture to the show. I think that just about does it for this video though. I hope you guys enjoyed the movie as much as I did. I'm already getting an urge to rewatch it again. Let me know in the comment section your thoughts on Spinel as a character, along with your opinions on Pink Diamond as a person, not a character. I'm curious if your thoughts on Pink Diamond have changed after watching the movie, or if they're still the same. As usual, be sure to leave a like down below if you enjoyed the video, and if you're new to the channel, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Peace out, take care, bye-bye.